down in the hadith is based on earlier scriptures as well. Okay, so the first thing that the Imam will do is leading the prayer, or if you're praying individually, you'll say Allah Akbar. We have this kind of hand gesture, Allah Akbar. So you can put your hand on here, or above the chest, or below the navel, or on, in the middle. Diversity is encouraged and welcomed in Islam. There's no problems about that. In this position, the Imam or the person who is reciting individually will basically recite the first chapter of the Quran, which is the just like the Lord's Prayer in Christianity. So if I ask you, Yusuf, to recite it, please.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahi r-Rahman r-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahman r-Rahim. Maliki yawm al-deen. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين. So this is the first chapter of the Quran, which says, which begins by saying, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, in the name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Praise be to the Lord of the worlds. The whole universe, not just one world. Alhamdulillah. Maliki yawmiddin, the master of the day of judgment. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. We only worship you, we only seek help from you. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. Then we ask, show us the straight path. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladina an'amta alayhim. Not the path of those who have gone astray. Ghayril maghdubi alayhim wa ladhdallin. Show the path of those whom you bestow your favor, not the ones who are gone astray. Ameen. And that's the first chapter of the Quran. And that's recited in every standing position when you're in prayer. And it's very similar to the Lord's Prayer. After that, you say Allahu Akbar, and you'll be a bending position like this. In this position, they'll recite Subhan Rabbi al-Azim, which means glory be to Allah, 3 times, 5 times, or 7 times. God likes odd numbers. Subhanallahi al-Hamida, banalaka ham. You'll be standing position like this, and then Allahu Akbar, there'll be a prostration position. Notice the sister. Now the forehead and the nose is touching the carpet, is touching the ground, and the hands are like this as well. And then Allahu Akbar, there'll be a sitting position, and then Allahu Akbar, there'll be a second prostration. In this position, by the way, you'll just be signing Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, and then Allahu Akbar, there'll be a standing position like this. Now Subhan Rabbi al-A'la means God the Exalted. You don't recite anything but it's basically exalting God all the time in these gestures. And then you're back to this square one again. Muhammad, peace be upon him. And then to end the prayer, you'll say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Turn the head toward the right. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Turn the head toward the left. And that's the end of the prayer. Assalamu alaikum means peace be and blessings be upon you. All the people who are on the right hand side became the mosque, and all the people on the left hand side. And if there's nobody there, then you say it to the angels anyway. All the angels on the right hand side, and all the angels on the left hand side. It's a beautiful, fantastic position of prayer where you really feel at peace. You know, you can be anywhere in the world. You can be facing calamity or a problem. Now, I went to Kosovo. You know, I said I did some relief work many years ago. I went to a number of countries. In Kosovo, it was in the middle of the war zone. And we were helping the KFOR troops in distributing food at that time. In the middle of the war zone, the prayer time came. And we did our prayer. The bombs were flying. Yes, I'm scared of death, of course, I'm a human being. I'm a weak human being. But when I was in prayer, I had that strength in me. So only God takes my life, only God gave me my life, and only God will take my life. And that's how we feel. You can get run over by a bus in Wakefield, you know, at any time. So you don't look at that. You look at how you live your life to the best of your ability, that you fulfill the commandments of Allah. And one of the most fundamental prayer, but the fundamental principle of Islam, is the attitude prayer, 5 times a day, to remind you who you are, the purpose of life. And to basically look at, you know, checking out your life all the time, and reflecting and wondering the purpose of life.